I've travelled 6,000 miles to seek help. I grew up in the UK, but I moved to St. Martin in the Caribbean about 7 years ago. I took 3 flights to get here, so it was pretty long. So I have desperately been trying to get rid of this, and I am running out of options, so I really hope Dr. Emma is going to be able to fix it. I have a massive keloid on the back of my ear. I've had it now for about 2 years, and it's been growing and growing and growing. It's really itchy, it's uncomfortable, gunky and gooey. I actually feel like blood pulsating through it. It's just gross. My boyfriend called it Jenny 2.0. It's actually got to the stage now where it's more like Jenny 9.0 because it's so massive. I have some concerns about my hearing. I'm not getting the same amount of sound in that I used to because I do think the position of my ear canal has changed because of this thing distorting it. I would say the keloid has knocked my confidence. Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2. I'm working as a journalist. When I'm out with my cameraman and making news stories, I do have to think about my keloid. And obviously I need to be able to put headphones on, and I can't put headphones on anymore that fit over my head. I wouldn't have travelled 6,000 miles if this wasn't a last resort. I'm also a little concerned that the keloid will come back. Maybe it's something I can never get rid of and I'm always going to have it.
Hi, I've got Jenny.
Hiya, Jenny.
Hello.
Hi. Come and have a seat. How are you?
Good, thank you.
So what are we doing today?
Well, I have come 6,000 miles to see you, Dr. Emma, to hopefully get Jenny 2.0, which is this giant...
Oh, my goodness.
Whoa. It looks like a love heart.
Or a kidney.
Yeah. So, whoa on 2 different levels here. Whoa, whoa for the 6,000 miles and whoa for the keloid. So how long has it been there?
She started like a pea size about 2 years ago.
Okay.
And now she's got to this size.
So that is a lot of growth in 2 years. Mm-hmm.
I did have a small keloid that formed.
Uh-huh.
I got the doctors to remove that.
Yeah.
Quite quickly, but they left the stitches in and said it was dissolvable stitches, but
okay.
A new keloid formed before the stitches had gone anywhere.
So you've hit the nail on the head, because that is what happens sometimes. And you have to remember, keloids form in response to injury. Whenever the doctor then cuts it off, that's another injury to the skin, and that can set off the keloid reaction again.
Mm.
So the follow-up is so important, and things like having injections of steroids or radiotherapy, they're the things that will stop it coming back. Okie doke, well, I can't wait to get my hands on it.
I would really like to know if this is the biggest you've seen.
Well, I've seen a few in my time, Jenny. And it is big, mm-hmm. But it's not the biggest. It's probably the biggest one hanging off the earlobe. If it's just attached to your earlobe, then that's definitely the biggest one, mm-hmm. I've seen.
OK, good.
But I've seen bigger ones on other bits. Let's have a look.
Oh, wow. It does look like a kidney when you do that, you know?
This is attached to the back of the actual pinna. Let's put this light on. This is a bright light, so just maybe keep your eyes closed. Okay, so that's fine there. So if we're able to lift this off and keep a part of the skin, just because the skin looks like it would come off the keloid scar quite easily, use that as a flap to go down.
Yeah.
Okay, so this keloid, Jenny 2.0, it's attached a little bit to the top of the kind of where the top of the neck comes up and joins the ear, but just a little bit. I'll have to cut it and cut it the whole bulk of the keloid away, mm-hmm. and then we'll stitch it up. Mm-hmm. Now, I do think the best way to try and ensure that it doesn't come back in the future is to have some radiotherapy to the area.
How does the radiotherapy stop it from coming back?
Whenever wounds are healing, all of the little fibroblasts, which are the cells that make the collagen, they go into kind of overdrive to heal a wound. When somebody makes keloid scars, they just keep making more and more and more and more. And what the radiotherapy does is it stops those cells from making the collagen, and therefore it doesn't go into that overdrive mode.
Okay.
Is that
sounds
all okay?
Great, as long as there's no chance of Jenny 3.0.
None of us wants a Jenny 3.0.
No, thank you.
Okie doke. Okay, yeah. So we'll get you all prepped for theatre then, mm-hmm. And we'll get it going. Sorry about this, okay? Wee scratch. Well done, you. Well done. This is just the anaesthetic going in. Very good. You're brilliant. Good job, you.
I'm delighted to be here and going to be even more thrilled. Oh, when it's all gone.
We're pretty snug now.
Okay. And then what I want to do is...
Have you got a purple marker pen? Are you, like, drawing your lines?
I do have a purple marker pen. But it's actually quite well defined. But it's fairly easy to see this. Okay, I'm just going to check the area. You can just tell me if you feel anything sharp or sore, uncomfortable. So I'm just incising into the skin, just around where this keloid is.
What is inside it, Emma?
So this is all scar tissue. So this is just very thickened scar tissue. I'm going to remove pretty much most of it in one go, and then I'll refine it slightly. It's difficult to get in to see exactly all of it because of where it is. So what we're trying to do is get the bulk of it gone so that we can create the little flap to set down on top of it.
Was my body working hard or overtime to create this?
Your skin's been working really overtime to create this. Some people don't make this much collagen in their whole body in a lifetime.
Right.
Can I get another blade? Oh, there's another one there, great. So keloid scars, whenever they're forming, they're really, really thick and fibrous. So we have to keep changing our blade quite frequently because it just blunts the blade. This is exciting because I think removing this is going to make a big difference here. I'm about to just take this last little part of it off here. So you ready?
I'm so excited.
Are you ready to feel about like a kilo lighter?
Yep.
Okay, here we go. Ba-dum! Yeah. Oh my gosh! I'm so... Oh my gosh!
It's rotten! So nasty! Oh,
like a potato.
Potato. Like a potato. Okay, so this is extra skin that I've taken off the keloid itself, which is a bit longer. And we're going to use this skin just as a little flap to attach down to the back of the ear. I love ears. I really love ears. I actually thought I wanted to be an ENT surgeon before I became a dermatologist.
Because of ears?
Yeah.
Because of your love for ears.
Oh, thanks. okay, so what I'm just feeling for here is just to check that there's no stretch on the skin there, and we don't want any stretch. Stretch is not your friend for keloids. But you don't have any.
Any
in
tension,
fact, there's a little bit of looseness, which is good. Yeah. Okay, you want to have a little look?
No.
Because we're going to have to put a really good pressure dressing on this.
So I'm not going to see it for a while.
So you'll not see it for a while. Okay, so can we grab a mirror, Motti?
Here you go.
Okay, you can...
Do you want to hold on to it?
My ears back in one piece. Oh, yeah.
You've got a little stitches that run all the way up in here and up to here. So the wee scar runs about this length in total.
Okay, okay. Wow.
Look at that. Dinky, dinky, dinky.
Dr. Emma, you've done a fantastic job.
Good.
So excited, Jess. I'm thrilled to have my ear back. Thank you very much.
My pleasure. Oh, I'm really, really happy with it. All you really want when you're removing somebody's keloid is to make sure that it can... all the keloid is gone and you can close it without any tension, and that's what we were able to do. The ear was all pushed forward and that was giving her a bit of difficulty with her job. So this isn't just a cosmetic issue, this is a functional problem too. So it's so nice then to see her beautiful little ear just flop back down into place. So all happy.